Hello students, now today we will start with chapter 9, Applications of Trigonometry, part 1. In the previous chapter of trigonometry, we have studied about trigonometric ratios. Now in this chapter, we will study about some ways in which trigonometry is used in the life around us. No doubt trigonometry is used in the life around us. Trigonometric ratios are used to find the height of a tree or a tower or width of a river and distance of a ship from a lighthouse. Without actually measuring them, we can find them using the trigonometric ratios. So let's take one example. A person sitting at a position P wants to measure the height of a tower. Here T is the top of tower and Q is the foot of tower. Person is sitting at P and at a distance of 20 meter from the foot of tower, he wants to find the height of the tower without proper measuring it. So we will see how trigonometric ratios are helpful here. Look at the figure carefully. This is a tower TQ, T is top of tower, Q is foot of tower. We suppose height of tower is h meter and person is at P, distance of observer from the foot of the tower is 20 meter and the line from which he is observing the top of tower is known as the line of sight. So here PT is the line of sight. If angle TPQ is 60, suppose it is given, then in right triangle PQT, TQ is the perpendicular and PQ is base for angle 60. So perpendicular by base will be tangent 60 and TQ, as we have exposed as H and base is 20, tangent 60 is root 3. So height is 20 root 3 and height of tower is 20 root 3 meter. So using the trigonometric ratios, we can find the height of any unknown object. Now we will read some terms. First of all, we have angle of elevation. What is the angle of elevation? If you observe the figure, suppose the observer is at O, and OQ is the horizontal line through the observer and he is observing an object at P. The angle of elevation of an object is the angle between the line of sight. In this figure, OP is the line of sight. Line of sight means through which line observer is observing the object. The angle between the line of sight and the horizontal through his eye is known as the angle of elevation. So angle of elevation of an object is the angle between the line of sight and the horizontal line when the object is above the horizontal through the eye of the observer. Suppose the observer is observing an object upward or he is lifting his eye upward to view the object, then angle between the horizontal line and line of sight is known as the angle of elevation. In this figure, POQ is the angle of elevation of the object at P. Object is at P and observed from O by the observer. Now, angle of depression. What is the angle of depression? Now suppose the observer is at P and he is viewing an object at O at downward and this is the line of sight from P to O and this is the horizontal line through his eye, that is PX. So angle between this horizontal line and line of sight, this angle XPO is the angle of depression. And if we take its alternate, it will be POQ because line PX is parallel to OQ. So angle of depression of an object is the angle between the line of sight and the horizontal when the object is below the horizontal through the eye of the observer. Suppose the observer is at more height and he is viewing an object at the lower height. Here PX is the horizontal line through P, OP is the line of sight, and OPX is called the angle of depression as observed from P. Angle OPX is equal to angle POQ theta, that is the angle of depression. Let's take one example. The height of a tower is 20 meter. Calculate the length of its shadow made on the level ground when sun's altitude is 60 degree. So in this type of questions, first of all read the statement carefully, then according to that you will draw the figure. Suppose we have a tower TQ of height 20 meter, T is the top of the tower, and angle sun's altitude from P is 60 degree, and length of the shadow is X. This is the tower and this is the length of shadow that we have supposed as X. So in right triangle TQP, this is the angle of elevation. In right triangle TQP, TQ perpendicular, PQ is base, perpendicular by base, tangent 60, perpendicular is 20 and base is X and tangent 60 root 3. So X will be 20 by root 3 meter or length of shadow is 20 by root 3 meter. So in this way, we are able to find any distance or any height using the trigonometric ratios. In your homework, you will write and learn definitions and do examples based on height and distance.